Yes, ma'am, you please start.
Good morning, everyone. I am Mrs. P. Durga, Assistant Professor of Chemistry from the Department of Humanities and Sciences. I welcome all the participants for two-day national level chemistry webinar on polymer materials biomedical applications. And today's session is molecular docking studies. Now, I wholeheartedly welcome principal of our college, Balaji Institute of Technology and Science, Dr. V.S. Hariharan Garu. Our today's program convener and head of Humanities and Sciences Department, Dr. V. Narayana Garu. Advisor of our department, Dr. V. Sudhakar Rao Garu. Before inviting our today's resource person, I feel an immense pleasure to introduce Sir Profile. Dr. E. Jagadish Kumar completed his MSc from Kavita Memorial Postgraduate College, Khammam, MPhil from Kakatiya University, Warangal, PhD from Chaitanya Postgraduate College, Warangal. Sir has an experience of 18 years teaching. Sir published 52 national and international academic publications. Sir also authored two textbooks. Presently, currently working as a professor in Department of Chemistry in Chaitanya Deemed to be University. Sir research areas are organic synthesis, heterocyclic compound synthesis, and biological evaluation, nanomaterials, and molecular docking studies. Thank you, sir. I request our sir Professor Jagadish Kumar Garu to proceed the session.
Sir. Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam. Good morning to all. Shall I share my screen, madam?
Yes, sir. You
proceed. Okay. Thank you. Session. Thank you, madam. Thank you. Okay, madam delivered my profile, a brief profile. Thank you, madam. Thanks to BITS College. Today's topic is molecular docking studies. See, past two decades, so many drugs are developed. See, docking, molecular docking studies, the preliminary key for another known to unknown drugs are drug site selective modifications, antiviral or bacterial preliminary information, which is based on computer-aided software programming. Suppose to synthesize a compound, organic synthesis is a hit and trial method. Okay, now means some of the reactions are succeeded, some of the reactions are not succeeded. Okay, now see, docking study gives us a clear-cut information whether based on the software designing algorithm, grid. Upcoming slides, I will explain what is algorithm, what is grid, what are the terms involved in the docking studies. See, the course target based one is SBDD, structure based drug designing. See, last 3 to 4 months we are suffering with corona COVID. Okay, now see, to develop a drug or to develop a vaccine known to unknown or to due to the DNA modification or mRNA modifications, see, docking studies are very useful to computer aided tools. See, what are the docking is nothing but in silico designing. Okay, now in silico designing involves some terms. Receptors are also called otherwise host, are also called lock. Ligands, guest or key. For a better understanding purpose, lock and key model, biology students all are familiar with, are each key opens its a desired key. Like that, see, docking is nothing but perfect matching in between receptor and ligand, or proteins and ligands. Docking, computational chemistry or combinatorial chemistry. See, binding mode, pose, and scoring is tells us about the information about the drug is utilized or not. See, ranking, hit molecule, lead molecule. During in pharmaceutical industry and drug industries, drug formulations and drug site selective modifications, to prepare a new drug or known drug by changing site selective modification to improve
another activity. In general, most of the cases, heterocyclic compounds, fused heterocyclics, okay, now heterocyclic compounds containing one atom, heteroatom, or two heteroatoms, fused system, okay, now. And what we call it as bicyclosystems, all are very potent, biologically potent. See, hit molecule, hit means ligand with high rank, means based on the literature or protein data bank is available. Okay, now on that, we are going to evaluate a protein hit or lead molecule. Lead molecule and hit molecule, pharmacophore. What is meant by pharmacophore? Pharmacophores are the substances biologically potent. Rational drug designing, QCSR drug designing, upcoming slides I will learn in detailed manner. Upcoming slides. See, this is the very brief introduction about drug design strategy depends on available information, protein structure. See, structure known, unknown, and known to unknown. I just initially at the beginning, I told earlier to you. See, known structure based designing means whatever the drugs are available, whatever the organic compounds are available, okay, now reported, okay, now based on that, we are going to what we called based on the literature. Some of the research students or scholars have interested to develop a new drug or new activity to improve the multi-drug resistance activity of known compound by changing site selective modification, by introducing substituents or functional group transformations, or by fusing two, what we call it as docking, best matching to improve the biologically active nature from the known to unknown, are reported to improve the activity unknown. Ligand based designing means, for our example, for our understanding purpose, 3D structure, virtual screening, 3D structure of a protein useful to bind the whatever the we are going to use ligand molecule. De novo designing is called virtual screening. Already during COVID time, we all are attending webinars, or virtual practical laboratories are also available. Okay, now to extra collaborate the knowledge. At this time, we are unable to go and do perform the laboratory, but docking tells us about, give a key point whether drug is useful or not. Okay, now after giving information, after performing by using suitable software, algorithm, grid, what happens? See, based on that report, binding energy, van der Waal forces of attractions, some data is available by machine language or computer output is coming. Once you take a molecule, do docking, okay, now, and binding with PDB, protein data bank, is available. Okay, now, AutoDock, Vina, 4.0, 4.2, 4.5 softwares are available. 4.5, 4.8 also, latest version is going on, like our software Android app applications like that. This is also 4.5, 4.8 upgradations are available, which is available in the net source also, PDB bank, protein data bank. See, in silico designing, what happens? What is meant by in silico designing? In silico designing involves four parameters, four association of four components, receptor-based one, either ligand-based one, combinatorial. Combinatorial means combinations, de novo-based one. First, we will discuss about a flowchart. I quoted here, receptor or structural based approaches. So first, what we do based on the literature survey or knowledge or reported molecules, first we have to identify active site identification of the molecule. To that, we are going to active site identification, assuming that it's a receptor. Ligand fragment grouping is also going to introduce like lock and key model. Suppose that receptor fit for ligand, okay, now then go for complex grouping and potential drug designing is going on. Suppose the ligand is not fit, change the receptor and go for back. Okay, now like I earlier told to you, chemistry synthesis is a hit and trial method. What about ligand based pharmacophore identification, where binding takes place, where active centers are, stereogenic centers, biologically potent centers are present, that is called pharmacophore identification. After that, see the known for already existing pharmacophore
Okay, now by doing site selective modification or by merging or lock and key model, we are going to modify the pharmacophore sites. First, pharmacorefer identification and followed by pharmacophore modification and fit for receptor. Suppose receptor, pharmacophore going to combines together, make it as a, like our friendship or shaking hand, fit together, potential drug is established or go for production. Suppose no fit for the, the receptor is not fit to the pharmacophore, we go for another ligand-based combinatorial-based approaches. See, what is meant by combinatorial-based approaches? Automated or semi-automated process, synthesis of large quantity compounds in small scale. So, okay, bulk to small. See, what happens? Small quantity scale. Smaller scales means at any quicker way, we are going to product desired target or target molecule. De novo based approach is purely based on molecular modeling studies based on only binding studies. Okay, now, and a large database and a machine language. So for understanding purpose, strictly speaking, molecular docking comes under artificial intelligence. See, this is the one of the diagram. Okay, now, Arab first proposed like the, these are the molecular docking studies. And what is docking? As I said earlier, best matching. This diagram represents two molecules find their connect association, means two, our understanding purpose, two close friends are there. Okay, now by the hooks or crooks, this positive and positive attitude or friendship, we both sitting together, solving problems or whatever, discussing doubts, discussion, clarification like that. But here not doubt discussions, receptor, ligand. Okay, now combines together to form a complex, make it as a best matching. The best matching leads to our lead molecule or desired molecule is go for animal studies or cell lines. See why, where docking studies are important. Suppose what happens, heterocyclic, as I said earlier, heterocycles, benzimidazoles, pyrazines, benzoxazoles, isoxazoles, are purines, pyrimidines, DNA purines are pyrimidine moieties, and recently derived flavonavir, ritonavir injections are also available in the market. And recently Dr. Reddy's laboratories also developed or introduced to the market tablets. Okay, now see why these all are in a short time, quicker time, how they are designing based on in silico designing. See, biological importance are very, very important to study docking. The what are the more steps? Compounds are docked into the binding pockets. Okay, now binding pockets. The binding strength increases activity of the lead molecule or whatever the chosen by you, okay, now for matching or docking molecular modeling studies, theoretical and practice, protein binding nature. First preliminary step. Second step, algorithm. So what is meant by algorithm? It's a very more important word. A process or set of rules to be followed in calculations or problem solving operations, especially by a computer or machine designing. I repeat, algorithm is a process or set of rules to be followed in calculations or other problem solving. What is meant by problem solving? Now, March 2nd week onwards, where the corona is a burning desire, a global disaster issue, pandemic issue. So a lot, so many scientists are working to develop a drug or vaccine. That is, problem solving approach is nothing but here in docking knowledge said to be named as algorithm. A large virtual databases are searched for active compounds, as I said earlier, to all PDB, protein data bank, is there. Most of promising compounds are synthesized or purchased. See, nowadays, what is going on? Now, in organic chemistry synthesis, and what happens starting like sigmoidage or whatever the reactant is, by knowing literature survey, our supervisor guidelines, a student or research scholar established a scheme, okay, either by step or three steps or multiple steps, what is going on, reaction proceeds taking places based on the structural or spectral
analysis, preliminary analysis, the compounds are prepared or not, the reaction is succeeded or not, or hit and trial method. But what happens? See, grid is there. Grid is the most important word, another word related to algorithm. A framework or space, network of lines that cross each other to form a series of squares or rectangles. I mean to say, suppose we, for understanding purpose, we sit in the classroom, only we are along with our classmates are present, we are class is going on, seriously class is going on. Once seriously class is going on, lecture is given, students are very interesting topic, assuming what happens? The pin drop silence or what is going on, the class is going in a smoother way. Suppose sir is absent, what happens? Some people are reading, some people are chit-chatting, roaring and murmuring, discussing like that. But here, grid is nothing but it's a fixed boundary. Best matching, protein and ligand binding takes place in a rectangular mode or square mode is the boundary for the grid. See, manual docking is also, just now I told you, dock or fit a molecule in the binding site. Binding means active center. Binding group on the ligand and binding sites are known, identify the operations and the binding studies and ideal binding distance. See, in docking studies, whatever the what kind of informations we are going to get from binding studies means van der Waal forces, hydrogen bonding, and the interaction in between protein and ligand. Proteins are software aided programming, computer aided programming available in PDB bank. I have already told to you. And ligand is nothing but your lead molecule going to be fixed like docking or molecular modeling. See, then whenever docking process is started, see, to get the operations and further synthesis bulk drug industry. The paired group are not directly overheaded and fitted for the binding distance, followed by what happens with both the ligands, and after that, the rigid fit. What is meant by rigid fit? Okay, now, next upcoming slides, I will discuss docking two types. Rigid docking, flexible docking. What is meant by rigid docking? Rigid means fixed. Suppose examinations are conducted by the university. Suppose each bench seating allotment is done by the examination branch. Two persons are seated in a bench. That is called rigid docking. What is meant by flexible docking? Flexible means suppose two persons are allotted a bench by the examination branch. But suppose what happens? The bench is damaged and also in the classroom, another empty bench is there. Assuming like that. See, that's why the person has supposed to take the permission from the invigilator and go and take that occupied the space and sit and write, continue her or his exam. That is called flexible docking. Like here, now and then we are using polymers and plastic materials are multi-purpose we are using. Like drugs are also, let me consider vitamins two types, water soluble and fat soluble. In olden days, two different categories are available, but now in advance, multivitamin tablets are available. See, multivitamin tablets is a tablet. Each tablet is containing salt form and along with water soluble and fat soluble vitamins. Sometimes what happens, either B complex or C vitamins or deficiencies identified by the prescription or physician or doctor, we go for only specifically take the desired vitamins. That is called identify the best fit of the molecule. Automatic docking. See, this is the diagram, is carefully listen, observe it. Defining the molecular structure, a binding site. See, second diagram, arrows are present. Arrows represents, these are the surfaces or active centers which can accommodate van der Waals forces of attractions in between receptor and what we call it as pharmacophore site. And so the similar study, blue balls, protein atoms, so probe atoms are introduced to protein. See, probe atoms means our lead molecule. Protein is nothing but a software designing program. AutoDock Vina is there. That is already available with different microorganisms. Proteins are available. Tools are available. Internet source, some commercial available. Free sources from the internet. what is going on? Probe atom going to fit for and make a friendship or going to combines to a protein to make a friendship or to make a complex binding site. See what happens, second diagram, convex surface re-entry is there where the space is accommodated, that space under accommodation surface is accommodated for the probe atom. Defining the controlling surfaces of the binding site with a probe atom. Probe means our lead molecule or molecule or whatever the target. Rigid docking, just now I told to you, fixed. See the molecule, what happens in summer season, what is going on, a person, weird sweater. Some uncomfortability is there. Rigid docking means there is a boundary. Okay, now we never expand further docking the molecule. Rigid means fixed. The dock programming fixed the molecule, ligand, okay, now perfectly bounded by the protein, that is called rigid docking by shape complementarily. Next, comparing distance between ligand atom and distance atom. Earlier I told to you, van der Waal forces of attractions, hydrophobic, hydrophilic interactions, intermolecular distances, all the information is given by the docking studies. See, for our first, all of you observe please once, first above diagram and below diagram. Above diagram, and I quoted 1A, observe it, just once, keen observe it, 6F, 7G, and 10E. What happens? Docking by overlapping of atom or pseudo atom. Okay, now pairing of 1A means mixing, perfect matching takes place from the above diagram. Whenever, once you observe below diagram, the 11, the naming 1, 2, 3, like probe atoms are there. Probe atoms are ligand, lead ligand. The black color shaded one is nothing but pharmacophore or what we call as binding site. 11 is search for out of the fitting. That's why that is called unaccessible binding site, unacceptable binding site. That causes steric crash. Clash, what happens? Some of the potency is declined without perfect matching of the drug. Just now at the beginning, I told to you algorithms. Use of a grid in docking program, I told. Once again, I'm repeating, grid or algorithm. What is meant by algorithm? See, it's a calculations, like our calculator tells us about doing subtractions, additions like that. See, that algorithm is a software computer-aided programming, tells us about problem solving operations by the computer, like our ECG output is coming, X-ray by knowing X-ray or by evaluating diagnostic reports, we are able to identify the where the deficiency, where the defects are present by the human being based on their ECG, whatever the desired problem they are going to do, desired ECG, CT scan, whatever, like algorithm here, very, very important. Grid also I told you, rectangular or square grids are programming or automatic programming is done. Just now we have discussed rigid, how rigid docking matches. First, once you observe this diagram, identify the hydrogen bonding group first and construct the surroundings for best understanding, for a better and better convenient way I'm doing. Okay, now open umbrella. Once open umbrella, what is going on? We can protect from sun rays or in summer season or rainy season, whatever, from rain. Like that, for understanding purpose, I'm telling not umbrella shape. It's a ICT tool based, I have quoted here, ICT based diagrammatic representation to understand in easiest manner. How protein binds to ligand. Make it as a best matching, like best friends or enemies. Lead molecule is fitted, rigid or flexible docking, that is desired, go for drug designing, drug synthesis, and potent drug. Otherwise, we go for next selection. And rigid docking or flexible docking, rigid docking, some drawbacks are there. The main object drawback is conformational. What is meant by conformational for understanding purpose? With respect to organic chemistry, cycloalkanes are there, cyclohexane, chair form, boat form is there, axial hydrogens, equatorial hydrogens, like that. A chiral molecule above the plane or below the plane, axial or equatorial or exocyclic double bond or endocyclic double bond, spherically crowded or less crowded information is partially given by the rigid docking studs. This is one of the drawback with respect to rigid docking. Due to this reason, to overcome the limitations or drawbacks from rigid docking, and the flexible docking is also developed from different conformations. See, that flexible docking is called as FLAG, flexible ligand oriented on grid. For understanding purpose, let me take an example. Let you take any Android phone, irrespective of company I'm telling, but SIM, either micro SIM or nano SIM, whatever, normal SIM, ultra SIM, whatever. Okay, now the SIM, without SIM, we are able to WhatsApp, we are going to do some other, but we are normal call, we are going to make a normal call instead of WhatsApp call. Even though Wi-Fi is available, WhatsApp is not available, assuming like that, we should make a call. Normal call means what happens? Normal call means some compulsory, there is a SIM activation is there. That's why, see, now Android phones are multi, bi-SIM or tri-SIM or multi-SIMs are also there. So the big SIM, big cell or small cell Android, but the SIM, short inserted member module, that SIM will operate all the functionings in the mobile phones. That's why FLAG, flexible ligand orientation on grid, is a program that generates conformational libraries called flexibuses, contains 10 to 20 conformations of each ligand. The docking flexible is a programming in a concise manner, I am telling. Various programs for generate the different ligand conformations, as I said earlier, exocyclic, endocyclic, axial, equatorial, eclipsed or staggered, chair form, boat form, which is more stable, which is more useful for the drug designing. All the information should be given from flexible docking, okay, now instead of rigid docking. The popular method is to the fragment the ligands and identify of the rigid anchor. Anchor means, just now I told you, anchor is a binding site. Okay, now like protein, and the like umbrella is the whatever the top umbrella protecting man is called the drug. Based on that framework, molecular framework is taking place. Suppose molecular never give positive reports, we go for and lead molecule. Just now I told to you direct docking 4.0 and 4.5 version is also there. Well, please all of you observe this diagram. Pyrimidine moiety is there, a tri-substituted pyrimidine left tie structure you have to observe. And somewhere else, a style group is there, somewhere else a CH3 group is there, somewhere else a C double bond O, N, CH3 group is there. The algorithm identify the rotables bonds. Algorithm, I told, na, calculation, problem solving, computer-aided programming is a process, set up rules. That's why algorithm tells us about where the molecular rotations are possible. Okay, now, and followed by the skeleton, second anchor, skeleton. Pyridine is the anchor. At pyridine is a tri-substituted one. At somewhere second position or third position and fifth position, carbon moieties are there. That is also called as anchor. Anchor followed by C double bond O is called first layer. And followed by N CH3 groups. Two CH3 groups are layer two. Some other groups are there, layer three. Like that, designing is given by the algorithm. The algorithm identifies the rotables bonds present in the ligand, identify the flexible or rigid region where the bond rotation takes place. See, to understand this bond rotation, in UG or PG levels or what is going on, Bayer strain theory is also there, CC bond rotation. Okay, now bond molecular flipping takes place, cyclic conformer into chair form to boat form, boat form to chair form. For example, eclipse to staggered, staggered to eclipsed. Nearly 3.7 to 13.7 kilojoules per mole energy is supplied by changing ascending or descending. Eclipsed conformer is converted into staggered, like that cyclic conformer chair form is converted into boat form, like that. First, this is identify the rotational bonds and the substituents. First substituent as layer one, and then apart from that, second substituent is called, followed by chain in the enhancing anchor one, layer one, layer two, molecule splits into the fragments is given by the algorithm or dock, direct dock, which is given by the automatically computer-aided machine learning language. We have discussed flexi, hydrogen bonding acceptor, hydrogen bonding donors, HBD. See, hydrogen bonding, hydrophobic groups, hydrophilic groups. Hydrophobic groups, phobic means hating, philic means loving. Hydrophobic, hydrophilic interactions. HBA stands for hydrogen bond acceptors. HBD stands for hydrogen bond donors. See, in general, hydrogen bonding two types. In preliminarily, very, very earlier, intermediate level or 10th class level, plus two level also, all are very familiar with this. Intermolecular hydrogen bond and intramolecular hydrogen bond. Based on that, we can predict the melting and boiling point. But here, interesting thing is, hydrogen bond donor, hydrogen bond acceptor, based on the number of hydrogen bonds. Okay, now, number of van der Waals forces of attractions. How much strength is, how much understanding, how much communication, okay, now how much association is present in between protein. Protein means pharmacophore and binding site and receptors are present by doing FlexiX. It's a program. And similar diagram, binding, how by, without the how binding takes place. This is the molecule, probe, left side, probe molecule. And this is the receptor, pharmacophore. Both are going to joining them like a matching docking. Docking involves inter van der Waals forces, intermolecular attraction. These kind of informations are identified by lead molecule, which is taken by you, where you are doing, what kind of research you are doing. And another IC2 based diagram I developed here, what happens? Identify the interaction center, anchor is there, NH group is there, bindings, double bond over there. See, just now we have discussed intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Anchor is another terminus. Binding site is another site, NHO. See, hydrogen involves a bond attraction. Oxygen is most electronegative. In between these anchor and binding site, attractions are established. The interactions are established. Interactions are nothing but positive interactions are established. Like our both are make doing to be associate together. Let's a problem is coming. Let's we sit and talk like that. Associate together. Whatever the interactions are binding nature or forces are distributed in between them to prepare a complex, matched complex. Okay, now molecular modeling complex. This is the what we call it as probe identification, de novo designing molecules and active sites. First case as pores are there and molecules, and the third diagram binding sites. I told matching the pharmacophore or ligand and active center to form lock and key model. This is also one kind of the hydrophilic interactions. Another structure I have taken here, binding site methyl group. And below binding site, same C double bond group. Why should I take these kind of means? See, like, you know, let me take DNA and ATP, adenosine triphosphate, nucleotides and nucleosides. What happens? Intermolecular A double bond T. Two intermolecular A double bond T represents two bonds or represents intermolecular hydrogen bonds two. G triple bond C. Three intermolecular hydrogen bonds are present. Like that, here binding takes place. And binding takes place, what is going on? Both are come sit in together, binding takes place and site selective is modified, okay, now to become active or potent drag. Some bond angle notations are also taking places based on the availability, accommodation of receptor, okay, now ligand should be accommodated by the receptor or active site, binding site. So, examples for molecular fragments are used already reported. These all are fragments. Fragment. This is called hydrogen bonding. How it takes place? The CH3 C double bond over CH3 is there. Suppose like nothing but acetone. It's an aliphatic compound, aromatic not. Non-sooty flame is observed by taking spatula, nail paint remover, or acetone, neutral compound. Suppose any hydrogen bond, hydrogen moiety, water, sometimes whatever polar moiety is asked, polar moiety, polar molecule is added, containing hydrogen, what is going on? Hydrophilic interactions are established. The bridging process, the benzene and pyrrole, and benzene and pyrrole intermolecular hydrogen bonds are established. Like that, examples for molecular bridging takes place. And this is also examples for representation by a template. These are the reported cyclohexene, okay, now pyrrolidine, morpholine, or cyclic ethers. Okay, now these are the molecules binding. sp2 or sp3 hybridized fragments are present. This is very important. Listen carefully. Modification of an enol to carboxylic acid. What happens? Enol. What is enol? Double bonded carbon is attached with OH group is called enol. Very, very primary basic study. What happens? Ketoenol tautomerism. Ketoenol tautomerism is also referred to be named as 1-3 proton shift. What happens? Keto form is converted into enol, rapid interconvertible. What happens? Enol form, I performing some reagent. Like Walker process or oxidizing agents like MnO4, whatever, based on the some reagents or organic methodologies, based on the reported literature or type of suitable reagent, what happens? I am going to oxidize the enol to or acetone to enol or acetone to directly carboxylic acid. That is modification. Enol ketone compared to enol form to keto form to carboxylic acid form. This carboxylic acid form is some extent potent compared to this enol and ketone form. And the second structure, CC single bond is there. First structure, cyclic bond, rigid bond, cyclohexane rings are fused with the carbon chain and modified, and ethers are there. Ether linkage is there with CC single bond, COC bond. The molecule property become more potent or flexible. And last reaction is called very, very familiar with reaction, Williamson synthesis ether preparation. Take iodo compound and sodium alkoxide to form ether. Compared to first step to second step is known, and this is also modified. The modification, you modify the molecule, it's a molecule. Second, this reaction, the reactant is not in directly. We are going to make it as like this molecule. The possible synthesis allowing the linkage of required the ethers. These molecules, number 3, 7, 4, 8, some number. These are not quotes. I quoted the below. The 10 most frequent substituents patterns of naphthalene in a database of drug like, I told now PDB bank, proton data bank. The number of referred to, number of occurrences, the binding nature once proton is bounded by the naphthalene. These are two bicyclic compounds are naphthalene molecules. Well, that number represents the number refers to number of occurrences in a protein binding nature, the drug-like compounds. This is virtual screening. Virtual screening, what happens? Like our virtual laboratories, during COVID, we are unable to perform when we go to college or any research lab. Okay, and like virtual laboratories are available in the net sources also. Okay, to obtain the knowledge. See, virtual chemically challenge in drug delivery. Chemical space means around 10 power 20 space. Up to that, chemical compounds or molecules are available. Available compound, 10 power 20, what we are going, available, not 10 power 20, very less amount, less region is available to us. Let me go for biological space, like protein, quaternary structure or primary structure, nearly allowed to the space of the biological space, 10 power 4 to 10 power 5. From that, validate target. Okay, now computational and combinatorial experiments are screening for the virtual screening for the binding, like grid or algorithm of the nature. Schema in drug discovery, target disease, suppose like corona, cancer or TB, whatever. Metabolic pathway, okay, now how the metabolic pathway is going on. Based on that, how can we destroy, how can we evaluate, how can we inactivate, how can we resist the either microbial, viral, or bacteria, or fungal, whatever, or parasite? That metabolic pathway we are going to refer. From that, we are going to select the target protein. Target protein, we should choose 3D structure is given by the PDB bank software.
After that, target protein, we are going to screening the database available. Some of the protein data bank is there. Some proteins are available in the database bank. We are going to screening. After that, we are going to lead optimization. These patterns are going on. First, what is going on? Virtual library, known reported molecules, a group of drugs or group of compounds, virtual screening. Our combinatorial library tells about HTS. What is meant by HTS? High throughput screening. Okay, now, like our some of the institutions like IJE, Mains, they are conducting screening tests. They need only cleverer students, not modern students or weaker students. They are going to what we call it as trained or knowledge fellows. They are, from that, they are going to give a training for NEET or GS, some extra. Like that, high throughput screening tells us about, like tea filtration. Okay, now. Tea powder is separated from tea, like that. High throughput screening filters, screens, whatever the reason, what kind of molecules are potent or useful to go for screening. And virtual screening, 3D, suppose some known and unknown is also there. Ligand based one, structure based one, active known and active inactive known strains are there. Similarly, searching, pharmacophore mapping and machine learning. And structural based one, we are going to docking. Docking means mixing for a better convenient way. All are familiar with complex compounds. What are complex compounds? Okay, now. A complex compound is made up of metal with ligands involving D2 bond. But here, pharmacophore targets lead molecule, pharmacophore binding together to form docking. This is also one of the representation of the docking. Database, same one kind of representation, cleaning the molecule. Okay, now post process, docking based screening, post process, dock, grid, glide, ICM. These are the softwares. By seeing what we called as a docking based screening, dock is a software, glide, gold is a software, glide is a software, ICM is a software, and also now and advanced Schrodinger is also available, very advanced. These are some softwares, lead compounds. This is virtual screening, diagrammatic representations. See, I presented here what we call it as pyrazine used with the pyrimidine moiety, heterocyclic based one. The lead optimization, how binding takes place, ligand based pharmacophore, molecular docking, and receptor based pharmacophore. These all are the information. Receptor based 3D structures is given by the docking software. And the introduction to protein ligand docking, how protein ligand takes place. Computer aided, earlier I have already told to you, known ligand, structure based drug designing, protein ligand docking, and no known ligand. Ligand is not known, that is comes under de novo designing. Computer aided drug designing, CADDD, of no use, need experimental data of some sort. Some data is available. Based on that, we are going to choose the targets. And finally, ligand-based drug designing, similar screening, pharmacophore searching, and quantitative structural activity relationships are going to be studied based on the report, docking reports. Protein ligand docking, what happens? The diagram, 3D diagram, color diagram, a structure-based drug designing, abbreviated as SBDD method. Structure means using protein structure and choose the binding site. Ligand is added, the green color, blue color is protein, and blue color, what is happened? One of the active binding site is circle by rounded by me, red color, and the ligand is there, and the green color. What happens? Both are comes in together, going to complex. That complex 3D information is given by the software. Pose means active or binding site. Use of docking, virtual I told now. Post prediction, whether molecule, lead molecule is potent or not, gives a preliminary information. After that, once a compound or a newly synthesized compound is docked by somebody based on the literature or protein data bank, a research scholar or a guide have interested to develop a site selective modification or new drug designing, synthesis, site selective, no reported molecule to site selective modification, are introducing a substituent, okay, now, are introducing two two kinds of association of two pharmacophores, two biologically active heterocyclic compounds are fused together to improve the biological activity. These all are preliminary information, okay, now given by Dawkins. Suppose, based on the machine learning, artificial intelligence or software designing, report is coming out. Schrodinger score delta G value. Delta G value, suppose as a standard data, I'm telling more than 8, that act as a, based on, suppose I have screened for anti-cancer activity. Okay, now more than 8.75 or 8.15 binding energy is present. The data represents the molecule is more potent and with respect to cancer, are based on the cell lines. See, suppose docking study, you have docked some molecules, you get good information, good results from the docking studies. Then after that, we are going to animal studies or ethical cell lines or breast cancer cell lines or whatever cell lines are available, where, in which field you are doing the research. Based on your research, your platform, okay, now these preliminary information, okay, now it's docking is a key or like synopsis or summary with respect to your, after performing biological studies using animals or cell lines, by getting a report, we are going to, then only you are going to correlate the molecules. Okay, now the data is matched. Once data is matched, what happens? Go for further drug design. Components for docking softwares, search algorithm, I told now, scoring. The best score means calculate the binding energy. Pose of the molecule is the binding site. Pose means binding or active site. Okay, final points, okay. Practical aspects, that is called preparation of protein structure. Say this is called what we call a heterocyclic moiety. The third structure is called cationic form. Sometimes what happens, drug targets or lead molecules are charged species, hydrophobic, hydrophilic interactions like aspartame, COOH, COO minus and OH groups are present. Some binding nature is improved. The ligand preparation, at first time I placed ICT2 designing. Enol form, double bond OH group is called enol. Proton transfer, what is going on, ketone forms are there. See, some of the drugs, keto forms are active. Based on the drugs, based on the reports, tautomeric forms, we are going to get highest score. These kind of functional group modification, site selective modification, binding energy, van der Waal forces of attraction, these informations, suppose good results are given by the software after performing, after conducting docking. Okay, now. The good score results, good potent, and search for poses. These are the relevant. This is ligand conformation. Initially, at the beginning, I told to you all chair conformation and boat conformation. I told left side, I told chair conformation and boat conformation. Chair conformation is called chair conformation D2D, dihedral. Boat conformation is called C2V. See, based on the rotation of CC single bond, intermolecular flipping of bonds by rotating angle, okay, like eclipsed, staggered, partial eclipsed, skew, chair form, boat form, twist boat, half chair, half boat, like that. The molecules are also, these all informations, orientation, combinatorials, bond angles, binding ability, tendency, all the informations are given by docking studies. This is one of the representation how binding takes place. Protein, the white color protein, the representation of ball and stick model, green color, red color is a molecule. Binding ability, it's a 3D diagram. And search for algorithm. At the initial beginning, I told algorithm. Algorithm means problem solving. It's nothing but a calculator, machine learning programming. See, that is developed by the machine learning people or experts. Say FRED, FRED, fast, rigid, exhaustive docking is advanced one from OpenAI. And earlier docking program only dock. See now, so many softwares are developed. Okay, and it's a preliminary key. Your lead molecule is potent or not. Then we go for bulk preparation and animal studies, ethical report and cell lines, etc. So many other biological parameters are performed by you or some other research scholars. This is called dock algorithm, rigid docking. See the thick color, black line is nothing but assuming like a binding receptor. The molecule is going to be hydrophilic interactions or hydrogen bonding interactions. Both are going to associate with each other to form a complex, matched complex dog. The final upcoming molecule is a lead molecule, is potent molecule, is given by given the information. This is also another strategy. Then this is also what happens, the first case. Rigid molecule, what happens? This is first shape, first stage of the docking method, a negative images. The negative images are nothing but what is circles are available, derivative from molecular surfaces of the protein, and go for second structure, what happens? First structure, what happens? Same molecule, but what happens? Orientations are very important. Orientations means for understanding purpose. For example, in polymer science, people prepare nanomaterials, top-up method, up-down method, top-down method, up-down method, left-to-right, Sol-Gel methods are present, like that. What are the orientations? See, docking, the orientation, the lead molecule, like lock and key model, a perfect key opens its desired lock, like that. The fitting of molecules orientation is very, very important, the spear shape. Once perfect docking is happened in between pharmacophore or active site to lead molecule or your chosen molecule or target, the active site, the ligands or the complex or the docked or molecularly modeled complexes are good, potent. To direct and design synthesis, what happens after getting this docking data, you go for biological studies, cell lines or animal or mouses or rats, whatever monkeys. After that, evaluation of those reports matches with the standards and the docking studies. Okay, now based on that, conclude your target molecule is very potent. Okay, now this docking study is nothing but, see, whatever the lead molecule is chosen by you, whether it is potent or not, without conducting experiment, without conducting laboratory preparation that give a software, automatically machine learning, computer aided designing, drug designing software, use some key points, whether the chosen target, drug target or moiety is useful or not. Then go for site selective modification and finally ethical reports, annual, what we call it as cell lines and whatever. Suppose your drug is anti-cancer, breast cancer, or whatever. So many cancers related to with respect to so many organs. And suppose TB, whatever. See, these are the things I have quoted here. Thanks to Wendell. Okay, I'm going to stop the screen share. Thanks to one and all. Sir. Madam. Sir. Madam. Durga madam.
Yes, sir. She will come.
Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I'm thankful to all the principal, HOD, and BITS College management, and also special thanks to Chancellor Sir, Vice Chancellor Sir of our Chaitanya Deemed Tube University, and Sir, proceed, Sir. Madam, proceed.
Thank you very much, Sir, for your nice session and a very informative session for us today.
Thank you.
Very new topic for all of us. Why? Because in engineering level, we are seeing many of the topics. This is one more a very new topic which we listen, and very interesting topic, sir, on molecular docking studies, the ligand receptors, whatever the examples you have considered on different drugs are also very nice session for us, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, there are some questions from the participants. May I ask, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Anurag is the student from Kits Engineering College, sir. The question is that, is there any methods to predict binding cavity size of an enzyme?
Binding cavity size of an enzyme, docking, madam, Schrodinger will give. I told now advanced softwares are also there, AutoDock, Glide, Schrodinger. Schrodinger gives the force of the size of the docking, size of the enzyme.
Oh,
Schrodinger is a software.
Okay. Software.
Yeah. Docking also, AutoDock, Vina, Glide, Gold, ANOVA. These all are softwares, madam. Machine learning, computer-aided designing softwares. Okay, now we will predict whether the lead molecule is suitable or not. Just a prediction. From getting information, we go for synthesis and biological evaluation, like cell lines, where you are going, where you have interested, either anti-cancer, antiviral, or anti, what we call it as multi-drug resistance. We are going to evaluate based on the animal studies and ethical reports. We will conclude. Okay, now we correlate the standard data from protein data bank. After that, we go for permission or bulk drug industry preparation. Next one.
Okay, thank you, sir. And one more question from Santosh, Vagdevi Engineering College, sir. How to visualize hydrogen bonds between protein and ligand?
So the 3D structure, docking, 2D structures and 3D structures are automatically, once our molecule is docked with protein, the protein data bank is available. At the beginning, I told to you, madam, PDB bank. Okay, now we are going to download that protein data bank. Whatever the desired or lead molecule, what type of drug or molecule you are going to, as a ligand, we are going to dock. Some processing is there, madam. After that, 2D, 3D structures are given by the software. The 3D structure information, 3D docking structures represents the strength. Based on the strength, we are going to delta G values are also there. The delta G value is more binding ability.
Sir,
madam.
One more question. Nikita from BITS Engineering College, sir. She's a student.
Yeah.
The question is, sir.
Okay.
Sir, what do you mean by VMD, visual molecular docking?
Visual molecular docking means, madam, suppose we go for 2D diagram, 3D diagram. Madam, 3D, 2D. 2D means we can see two dimensions, the x-axis or y-axis. Once we get a 3D diagram, okay, now we will rotate, we will, what we call it as, once I have docked my lead molecule to protein from protein data bank, the molecule, where region is bounded to the protein, I mean to say is, madam, amino acids, the sequence of amino acids, the intermolecular or hydrophobic, hydrophilic interactions. Proteins are nothing but polypeptide chains, madam. Polypeptide chains are made up of peptide chains. Peptide chains are made up of peptide bonds. Peptide bonds are formed association of amino acids, madam. At where hydrogen bonds, our lead molecule is going to be bind, either hydrogen, hydrophilic and hydrophobic, that number. Suppose, let me take insulin, madam. Insulin, 16 disulfide bonds are there. Suppose, assuming a protein, a molecule is docked by the, docking studies are performed by a desired drug or compound molecule. Okay, now, the strength, by knowing 3D structure, the position where the binding site is, the location is also we can evaluate. Like, madam, our GPRS, we are moving. Okay, on the road, by car, we are unable to know the address. Any persons are not available to you. What we are going? We are going your destination. Once Google Maps, what is going on? That tells us about the Google Maps, helps us information to your destiny, or 3 kilometers or 10 kilometers. Like that 3D diagram represents where binding is happened, which amino acid. The type of amino acids are 20, madam, known amino acids, some that essential, non-essential also there. That clear cut information is given by 3D diagram. Okay, madam.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. These are the questions from our
participants.
Now I request our
thank you, madam. Questions are also very.
Now
questions
I request.
Are very good, madam. Five.
Thank you, sir. Now I request our today's program convener, Head of Humanities and Sciences Department, Dr. V. Narayana Garu to speak a few words on this session.
Thank you, madam. Really, I am thankful to today's resource person, Professor E. Jagadish Kumar Garu from Sri Chaitanya Deemed University, saw delivered a talk on molecular docking studies. Though I am a mathematician, today I could understand something about drug strategy design, silico design, docking types, docking programs, and SAR covered a wonderful topic called virtual screening and all. Really, sir, I am appreciate on behalf of Humanities and Science and BITS College, really I'm very thankful to you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I know you are busy with your classwork. Sir told me that I spent 2 days, whole and day, I prepared the slides. Really, I'm very grateful to you, sir. Time with us. Really, you delivered a nice talk on molecular docking studies. We are very thankful to you, sir. Definitely, we are going to use your services even in the future. And I'm thankful.
Yes, sir, I will do, sir. Sure.
Thank you, sir. And I'm thankful to Mrs. P. Durga, coordinator for this 2-day national level chemistry webinar, for her services and all. And my sincere thanks to all my dear chemistry faculty and also my dear staff for their continuous encouragement and support. And I'm especially wholeheartedly my sincere gratitude towards the management. This is the 4th national level webinar we are organizing. This is done only by the support of the management, principal, Dr. V.S. Hiran Garu, chairman and secretary and AO and all the HODs. So, and regarding the certificates and feedback, few instructions to the participants. So I request all the participants, now we are going to post feedback link in the YouTube chat box. That link will be active up to 6 p.m. today. So I request all the participants, you please give your valuable feedback. Whatever the feedback, you please give genuinely so that we are here to provide you better programs in future. With this, I thank the coordinator, Mrs. P. Durga ma'am, and also today's resource person, Professor E. Jagadish Kumar Garu. Now I request Mrs. P. Durga to give vote of thanks for this session. Over to Mrs. P. Durga.
Thank you, sir, for your nice words on this session, sir. It's the time for vote of thanks. I feel privileged to propose vote of thanks. My heartfelt and sincere thanks to our college management, our chairman, Dr. A. Rajendra Prasad Reddy Garu, and secretary, Dr. G. Rajeshwar Reddy Garu, and our principal, Dr. V.S. Hariharan Garu, and our HOD of Humanities and Sciences Department, Dr. V. Narayana Garu, for their continuous support towards to this program and their efforts towards to our 2-day national level chemistry webinar program. And I'm very grateful to our today's speaker, Dr. E. Jagadish Kumar Garu, for accepting our invitation, sir. And you have given your presence today with a very, very nice informative session to us, sir, on a very new topic, and which is very useful to us, and we gained some knowledge on this topic today. I'm very thankful to you, sir. And my special thanks to all the Balaji Institute faculty members and my department colleagues and all my dear participants who has been participated yesterday and today and make a very grand success. Once again, my sincere thanks to our yesterday's speaker, Dr. E. Lakshmi Narayana, sir, and our today's speaker, Dr. E. Jagadish Kumar, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for all of us. Stay home, stay safe.
Thank you.
Okay, with this, we are going to close this session. Thank you, all of you.